Sing off. All new, next on NBC.
The battle has been raging for weeks. Tonight is the final push.
This is history in the making. Season 3 is crazy.
Four groups have risen to the top.
Congratulations.
I love y'all.
But only three can lock down a coveted spot in the finale for a shot to change their lives forever.
I have the judges' results in my hand.
For one group, it all ends tonight. The $200,000 cash prize and the dream-making Sony Music recording contract are just heartbeats away.
Getting the recording contract, it would be a dream come true. It would be amazing.
But to take one step closer, the top four will face our toughest challenges yet.
We're going to have to work harder than we ever have.
First, they must combine two chart-topping hits from completely different artists into a single show-stopping mastermix.
It has to be great, or else we won't be in the finals.
Then, they'll deliver a song chosen by our judges to put their group to the ultimate test.
Judge's choice, baby. This time we got to choose the songs.
Yeah.
But remember, there's no room for mistakes.
That's right.
And it all leads up to a fateful elimination as the top three are chosen.
We can't go home now. We're too close.
Then we open the voting lines and turn this competition over to you. The fight for the finale is on. America will decide who takes the title. Music like you've never heard. A competition like nothing you've ever experienced. And it all begins with a breathtaking opening number. This is The Sing-Off.
Yeah.
Lachey, and welcome to the sing-off. You just witnessed our top four groups singing a master mix medley of hits by Gwen Stefani, The Verve, Katy Perry, and The Who. Our most epic season ever began with 16 vocal bands fighting for the $200,000 and the Sony Music recording contract. And after weeks of non-stop battle, the four best groups in America are left standing. The Kings of Charisma, the Dartmouth Airs. The groundbreaking remixers, Pentatonix. The exciting hip-hop daredevils, Urban Method. And the maestros of a classic sound, Afro Blue. These groups delivered powerful performances and poured their hearts into every single note this season. But for a shot at the title, they'll have to win over our heavy-hitting trio of judges. The spectacular, spectacled a cappella champ, Ben Folds. The Grammy-nominated chart-topping songbird, Sarah Bareilles. He's got a PhD in R&B. Boys to Men's, Sean Stockman. Tonight is double trouble for our top four. First, they'll tackle an all-vocal master mix, blending two huge hits into a seamless performance. Next, it's judges' choice, songs handpicked by our judges to put the groups to the ultimate test. After both performances, the judges will make their final decision of the season. Three groups will pick up their mics in the championship. One will fall from glory tonight. The pressure is on. A single missed note could cost them a spot in the top three. And at the end of the show, we're going to open the voting lines across America. Your votes will crown our winner on next week's action-packed live finale. When we come back, the vocal prize fight begins with the remixing renegades Pentatonix, smashing together CeeLo and Kelly Clarkson. The sing-off is counting down to the championship. Any song with an all-vocal arrangement. But tonight, our sing-off final four have got to merge two songs with different tempos, keys, and styles, and somehow make them work together with just their voices. Let's kick it off with a group of vocal dynamos who've stayed strong all season by giving every song a futuristic twist. Now the daring members of Pentatonix are going to combo two hits about breaking up to try and break into the finals.
Let the beat drop.
Pentatonix put on another stellar performance with Usher's OMG. And then brought the house to its feet with their passionate rendition of Marvin Gaye's Let's Get It On.
I can't express enough how incredible that was.
I mean, it's a scary feeling. I'm always nervous and anxious, but then after hearing things like that, and it's just like thrilling.
This week, we're doing two songs.
We're doing a master mix of Since You've Been Gone and Forget You.
With our master mix, we're having trouble jumping from song to song.
I think that knowing that this is the most important performance of the season is kind of freaking us out, and I think it's hurting our arrangement.
I'm just so afraid people are gonna be like, they ruined Forget You, or they totally ruined Since You've Been Gone, yeah, because we're changing it up so much.
We're just not sure if people will say, you know, this is the group that needs to win.
I don't know if we can do this, seriously.
I know all of our voices are tired, and we're all mentally exhausted as well, so, I mean, all of us are struggling.
This is the last opportunity to show America we want this. We want to be here.
I guess you never felt.
No, you were wrong.
Yeah, you did an extra line. Yeah.
We really want to win so we can keep doing this and go on tour and record and live our dream together. We don't want this to be the end.
Hoping to leave the judges with another unforgettable performance with a master mix medley of CeeLo Green's Forget You and Since You've Been Gone by Kelly Clarkson, here's Pentatonix.
Here's the thing, we started out friends. It was cool, but it was all pretend. Yeah, yeah, since you've been gone.
I see you driving round town with a girl I love. I'm like, forget you. I guess the change in my pocket was wasn't enough. I'm like, forget you and forget her too. Yeah, if I was richer, I'd still be with ya. Ain't that some
shit? Ain't that some shit?
And with the pain in my chest, I still wish you the best. With the spaghetti, oh.
But since you've been gone,
oh no!
How can I put it? You put me on.
To get you and your stupid love song.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Since you've been gone.
Since you've been gone. And I pity the fool for the love.
I just wanna be with you.
Why you wanna hurt me so bad?
Pentatonics. Wow. Let's go ahead and go right to our experts. Ben, what'd you think?
Nice work. I mean, going from the Kelly Lo Green to the CeeLo Clarkson was really seamless. You knew you had a non sequitur after non sequitur to deal with, and you just made that entertaining. Avi and Kevin, you guys are getting to be amazing rhythm section. You guys. Watching the battle between Avi on bass and Kevin on the beatbox was bitching. I mean, it's like you guys gave voices to the instruments. You're getting like a really tight touring band that's been out doing this for years, and you always come up with some kind of trick that you don't expect, because I keep thinking they're going to run out of stuff. And you didn't, and you did something really cool. It was great. I heard you guys out of tune for the first time of the series yet. It wasn't serious, but I think it was in the second chorus of God. Which song? I don't know. It was going back and forth so well, and you just brought the whole thing together and made it entertaining. So, yay, Pentatonics. Nice work.
Sarah?
That was a great performance. First of all, our lead singers here, Kirsty and Scott. What I loved in this performance is that you guys were telling a story with your motion and your choices on stage as well. And you ditched Scott for Avi in the end, and then it worked out, so. But it was really entertaining. You guys were telling a story, and that was a lot of fun to watch. I was smiling and grooving like a loser, so I think you've done your job. Thank you.
Sean?
I'm so used to you guys like actually doing like these like real ill breakdowns and all this other stuff and transforming all that stuff, but you know, you didn't do that and I still enjoyed it. You seamlessly put together those two songs where it was almost like, okay, they're singing to Kelly, nope, it's okay, now they're singing that one, now they're singing that one. It was just so fluid how you guys did it, you know, just creating something different that even the artists themselves might not have thought of. Avi and Kevin, you guys are no longer named Avi and Kevin, okay? I officially name you Meat and Potatoes. Because you made the whole music mega mix thing work because you stayed constant. You're so intelligent when it comes time to arrange certain things because you know how far to push the envelope, and that's why you guys are so enjoyable to listen to. So good job, man.
All right, thank you, Sean. And Pentatonics will be back again later for the judges' choice round. Thanks, guys. Don't forget, all the songs you hear tonight are available for download on iTunes. After the break, Denver studio musicians Urban Method fire it up on a mix of songs made famous by Nelly and Madonna. And at the end of the night, the voting lines open to America. The sing-off is kicking into high gear. records. Our next mixologists are a Colorado crew that brings a gritty hip-hop edge to every performance. But for their Master Mix Challenge, Urban Method is going to turn up the heat and blend a sultry classic with a dance club hit. Last week, the ladies of Urban Method gave a powerhouse performance that propelled the group forward in the competition. Do what you wanna do.
That was awesome. I feel like I keep getting surprised by you ladies. You're stepping out and finding your voice.
Our master mix this week is Nelly's Hot in Here with Peggy Lee's Fever. We had originally planned to have Katie on the Fever solo.
As it was going on, I didn't feel like it was right.
You guys, I need your help, and I need you to tell me what sound do you like.
It gets pretty tense sometimes in rehearsal. There have definitely been some emotional moments.
I think that Liz should sing the lead.
As soon as he said that, it all kind of made sense because she has that voice that fits that song.
The master mix has been really difficult. You have sultry and sexy, then you have fun and carefree. And we've been having a difficult time fusing the two moods together.
What's the use? I said.
No. Then we go back to the
We go back to
right, 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 right.
We are hoping to just make a statement, just solidify ourselves in this competition and leave no doubt in anybody's mind that we should be going to the top three.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Hoping to get the temperature rising, performing a master mix medley of Hot in Here by Nelly and the Peggy Lee classic hit Fever, here's Urban Method. Sarah, sweating a little bit?
I mean, my God. Wow.
What'd you think?
That was sexy, you guys. Yeah. That was amazing. I'm so glad you guys figured out a really smart, cool way to meld those two songs because Fever is really restrained and it's seductive, but it's not over the top. And Hot in Her is the exact opposite. So you guys made a really successful master mix of those two songs. Miss Liz, You are so hot up there. That was awesome. I'm so glad. You're right in your sweet spot. That is where your voice just shines. I loved the breakdown where you guys brought it back to the jazzy feel of Fever. I came away a little hot in here. And hot in her. Hot in her. That was good.
Sean, what'd you think?
I loved it. Liz, that was such a sexy lead, how you brought that out. You have such a beautiful, raspy alto. You know what I mean? It was perfect for that. The cool thing about this particular performance is that it was so much going on in a good way. It was eye candy, it was ear candy. I honestly believe that was the best arrangement you guys have done because it showed so many characteristics of the groups and the way that you blended them all. I guess you needed to do a master mix to actually show that off, but you guys pulled it off great. Good job.
Ben?
That was really good. It was a really engaging arrangement, and not so much that it wore you out. Like, it was still dynamically right, and it was all really great. Richard, was that a saxophone? Right on. Not many drummers play saxophone, too. That's very good. That's very cool. And the last transition, when you went actually into the old-style version of Fever, was really effective. You got stars in the group, and you all share it really, really well. You guys are just great. Nice work.
Very well said. All right, we'll see Urban Method back in a bit for their Judges' Choice performance. Thank you, guys. Coming up, the vintage voices of Afro Blue blast us into the stratosphere with a duo of hits by R. Kelly and Nicki Minaj. And we're just 1 week away from our biggest finale ever, with the momentous return of this season's top 10 groups, plus performances by superstar guests. The sing-off is amping up.
Avril Lavigne, Scotty McCreery, Rodney Atkins, and CeeLo Green from The Voice. See live performances from Sister Act, How to Succeed with Daniel Radcliffe, plus the sensational Spider-Man. And don't forget, after Santa comes, it's off to the National Dog Show presented by Purina.
Did you know you won?
It all starts 9 a.m. everywhere, Thanksgiving Day, here on NBC.
Week after week on The Sing-Off, these groups have given us stunning vocal versions of the greatest songs in history. But tonight, they're delivering hit and master mixes, combining multiple tracks into one spectacular performance. Next up, a group that's impressed the judges with intelligent arrangements that tap deep emotions. Now, just one step from the finale, the members of Afro Blue need to push their passion to new heights onto high-flying hits. Last week, Afro Blue delivered a strong and emotional performance with We Belong Together. We belong together.
So beautiful to watch you lose yourself in the music.
You got the best of my love.
But there wasn't enough momentum with The Best of My Love to keep them out of the bottom two for the second week in a row. The group that still has a chance, Afro Blue.
So, Afro Blue, we've been in the bottom two quite a few times, and we definitely can't be there this week. We won't be there this week.
One, two.
Afro Blue's master mix this week is I Believe I Can Fly by R. Kelly and Fly by Nicki Minaj.
I came to win, to fight.
The lyrics fit Afro Blue so well, and we are so connected to the message that we came to win, we came to conquer.
The R. Kelly song is the easy part for us.
I don't know how to.
But the Fly by Nicki Minaj is a little more difficult.
Everybody wanna try to box me in. 17 every time it locks me in. Oh.
I am doing one of the rap verses. It's scary. I'm not a rapper at all.
We really want this Sony contract. It will mean so much for our careers.
This week, one mistake means elimination. We're really gonna just work to being perfect.
Hoping to soar into the top three with a master mix medley of I Believe I Can Fly by R. Kelly and Fly by Nicki Minaj and Rihanna, here's Afro Blue.
I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win, to survive. To fly, to fly.
can fly.
Afro Blue. Very, very nice. Sean, what'd you think?
Nice blend of that Afro Blue style along with a gospel feel to it. It had a soul, a spirit to it. It lifted everybody up. Mariah, I know you don't rap, but you fooled me tonight. Mariah Minaj.
That was all right.
I hope you understand how much you've grown in the midst of this competition. I've enjoyed watching you guys, you know, take the rides. You went high and you had your share of lows and things of that nature. But I think that in the midst of it, you learned a lot about yourselves, and you guys are a lot deeper than when you first came here. You showed some beauty tonight. That was great.
Yeah, it was cool. You blended the two songs together and you used the complex harmonies in your arrangement, which allowed the two distinct melodies to flow seamlessly back and forth. Mariah, that was really good. What you did was good. And you don't hear many rappers that end it with the way you sang that.
Yeah, right, right.
That. That had a lot of attitude. I would like for the accompaniment behind Mariah's rapping part to have held on to it a little bit more, not quite been as much of a transition, maybe even drop out. It could have just used some space there. Thing is Mariah was so powerful that no one's ear is going to go towards that. Thought it was good. You know, I haven't heard a master mix that was moving like that. That was a nice job, y'all.
All right, Sarah.
I love you guys in this competition because I feel like you show so much heart and so much humility and then so much courage on top of that. You're such powerhouses. I mean, Christy and Trent, I really love your voices and great performances from both of you on this. I loved the theme that came out of this combination. It was about empowerment and believing in yourself. I think it's only going to get deeper and more profound as you grow as a group, and you're so talented. So thanks for being here.
Thanks, Sarah. And Afro Blue will be back one more time with their judges' choice song. Thanks, Afro Blue. When we return, the Dartmouth Bears try to catch lightning in a bottle fusing Lady Gaga with the Rolling Stones. And later, an all-important elimination. Four groups began the night, but only three will land in the epic finale one week from today. The sing-off. Keep it tuned. Medleys. They're fighting for a spot in next Monday's explosive live season finale, where one of these groups will be named the best vocal band in America. These next guys have risen to the top of the class with nonstop energy and powerhouse performances. But for this challenge, the Dartmouth Airs have to match the stagecraft of two of the biggest live acts in music history. With both of their R&B performances, the Dartmouth Airs provided enough style and refinement to stay in the competition for another week.
That was a wonderful performance. Thank you.
This is going to be a hard week, but I think we all really, really want to be in the finale.
This week we're doing a master mix challenge where we have to take two songs and combine them into one. The two songs we're doing are Born This Way by Lady Gaga and Sympathy for the Devil by the Rolling Stones. Of wealth
and tame. I'll be singing the Stones, trying to pull off Mick. Bringing these songs together has been difficult just because they're from such different genres and styles.
We originally gave Born This Way to Ethan.
We're a little short.
Come on, gotta get this. We then decided that since it's so late in the competition, we should just stick with the safe choice, which was Michael, since he's done a solo before.
There's no other person that we are more comfortable singing behind than Michael.
Winning the sing-off and getting that recording contract would mean the world to me.
There has been no all-male collegiate group to win the sing-off, so we want to be that group that holds that title up.
There's no room for error. There can be no pitch problems, no choreography slip-ups, no solo lead slip-ups. We want to make top three so badly.
To go home at this point of the competition would be devastating.
trying to roll all the way to victory, performing a Mastermix medley of Lady Gaga's Born This Way and Sympathy for the Devil by the Rolling Stones, here are the Dartmouth Heirs.
Just put your paws up, because you were born this way, baby.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. So many men, so faithful. I was there when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Lord, made damn sure that Pilate washed his hands to see his face. Pleased to meet you. Won't you guess my
glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, 'cause he made you perfect. So hold your hand, boy, and you'll go far. Listen to me when I say,
ooh, pleased to meet you.
I'm on the right track, baby, I would fall this way.
Yes! The Heirs! Ben, what'd you think?
Wow, that's a lot to take in. Where do I start? Man, it's like 100 dudes on stage. They split up into two parts, have two different theaters going on at once, and it's a really great concept how at the end you had the devil versus the devil, or what? I'm not sure who was the devil. You both gave it hell. It's good. The bass was going out of tune a little bit. Danny got a tough job because you're the only bass there in the middle of a lot of other people. So I totally understand why that is. Good news is that those are the parts where you're the most entertaining and it's probably the most engaging to the audience. The Jagger lead, in that it wasn't overly Jagger, Brendan was really cool. That was a good interpretation. Michael, you're always great. So Ethan, every musician has been in a band and has had to go through that moment where you're doing a part and it's not the best for the group for that moment. And it takes a lot of humility to back off and say that that's okay. And I applaud you for that. Nice job, the whole group, for hanging together on that one. And Ethan, I salute you. Nice work, guys.
Sarah?
I'm with Ben. That was a lot to take in. There was so much happening, and that is sometimes where you guys shine the most. And for me, this one fell off a little bit. But, you know, that being said, you guys chose the perfect leads for these songs. Brendan and Michael, you guys deliver with so much passion and so much conviction. It is really a joy to watch you on stage. You sing your asses off so consistently. There's so much love between you guys on stage. You're so much fun to watch. So yeah, thank you for that. That was great.
Sean?
You guys definitely have a flair for the dramatic in a good way. I mean, it's theatrical every time you guys go on stage, and it's always enjoyable. Not my favorite performance of you guys because I'm so spoiled because of how good you guys really are. But it's a feat in itself to mix an ultra-modern pop song with classic rock royalty. I love the battle waging between good and evil and, you know, that whole thing. And that was good. You guys are always entertaining. So thanks.
Thanks, Sean. We'll see the Dartmouth Air sing again in the second half of the show. Thanks, fellas. All four contenders flex their muscles with Mastermix medleys, but when we come back, the experts take over. The judges' choice round leads off with the mind-bending voices of Pentatonix. Next week's live finale is just within reach on the sing-off. Sing-off groups are stepping up to the plate for the judges' choice challenge. The experts chose the playlist, and the top four have got to deliver because $200,000 and a recording contract are up for grabs. First up is our Texas team that's always pushing the limits of a cappella. We checked in with the judges to get their thoughts on the inventive vocalists of Pentatonix.
Pentatonix, freakish. These guys are making it hot with five. That's hard to do. Oh my gosh,
every one of those kids packs a punch in a big way. For you, I'd risk it all. I think Pentatonix could be competitive in the music world. They're really innovative and they fuse pop and a cappella and make it into this really cool thing.
You're doing things that are the future.
Their arrangements are very risky, and they work. They did some real ill stuff with Video Kill the Radio Star. They made themselves skip. Video could
kill the radio star. Who would think of that? You know what I'm saying?
Pentatonix challenge is gonna be, are they gonna do anything new? I mean, how much more new stuff can come out of them?
The whole trick is don't become too ambitious with their arrangements where they lose sight of the feeling of the original record. That could be the difference of them staying or leaving.
All right, let's see what the judges have in store for Pentatonix. Sarah, what song did you guys choose?
Well, Pentatonix has a style all their own, and they are always so innovative in their arrangements and pushing the boundaries. So we wanted to challenge them to reimagine a song that has a lot going on, a super powerful lead vocal and some pretty serious drums and percussion. So we chose Florence and the Machine's Dog Days Are Over.
Thank you, Sarah. Hoping this day ends with a spot in the finale, performing this year's mega hit, Dog Days Are Over by Florence and the Machine, here is Pentatonix.
Happiness hit her like a train on a track. Coming towards her, stuck still no turning back. She hid around corners and she hid under beds. She killed it with kisses and for all it she fled. The dark days are over. The dark days are done. The horses are coming, so you better run. Run fast for your mother, run fast for your father. Run for your children, for your sisters and brothers. See all your love and your loyalty behind. You can't bury it with you if you want to survive.
The dark days are over. The dark days are gone. Can you hear the horses?
Brothers, leave all your love and your loyalty behind. You can't carry it with if you want to survive.
The dark days.
Pentatonics. Ending it on a high note. All right. Sean?
Pentatonics, man, you guys are ridiculous, man. Like, that was like audio drama. We're coming down to the wire of this record contract. So you want to have something that you know that you can play, and everybody is like, yo, that is crazy. That's what, you know, this whole thing is about. Mitch. Woo! I'm going to tell you, man, you have one of the prettiest voices I've ever heard in my life. It was so many elements that was just ear candy, from Kevin and the horse hooves and the choo-choo trains that you were doing, to, you know, the breakdown to Mitch. And that was so ingenious, like the way that you guys were able to just give Mitch his moment. And you were, oh, that was, man. It was a wonderful performance. That was awesome.
Sarah.
You guys are just, you're riveting on stage. You know how to use your instrument, and it's a God-given gift, and you guys all have it. So really, really fantastic performance. I learned today that three of you are 19 years old. Mr. Scott, singing the lead on that, is 19, am I correct? Miss Kirsty is 19 years old, and Mr. Mitch is 19 years old as well. So what we have here is a young group of people that show so much promise and potential to become even that much more great over time. I love hearing you sing. Well done, you guys. It was fantastic.
Ben?
A surprise is a rare gift in a musical arrangement. They're hard to come by, and you guys always give us one or two of those in every performance. And that one was where Mitch popped in this time. And it's not just about the fact that he has a beautiful voice, which he does, partially the way you guys set that up. And then you get a surprise. You guys were so focused. And Avi didn't even want to let go of the focus after the song was done.
Yeah.
He was just like,
my God,
that. That's really in the moment amazing. Thanks for the surprises, guys. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Nice work.
All right, judges. We'll find out in moments if Pentatonics will be standing tall in the season finale. Thank you, guys. Coming up, we'll find out what epic hip-hop jam the judges picked for Urban Method. We're gearing up for next Monday's star-studded finale, where we'll not only crown the new champ, but our top three will share the stage with our very own judges. Sing off. Stick around.
This has always been my dream, and now that I can do my dream and like to be recognized like I have it all seen, it is just a dream come true to me, and I feel so blessed to share with these people. They're my family now, and I want to do this for the rest of my life, and I want to do it with them.
Of course.
Every day is so wonderful, and suddenly
she's an actress, not a waitress.
It's hard to breathe.
I think she's a star.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Don't you bring me down.
Close with it.
When the sun is shining through.
What a voice!
And the clouds won't stay.
New York is like the promised land.
Everywhere we go.
We worry. It's so competitive, all that rejection.
People spend years on a musical. Why don't we just do it?
All the other times, we are beautiful.
It's spectacular work.
Don't you bring me down.
You're great in this.
The Monday after the Super Bowl, a star is born. Smash, coming to NBC.
We're moments away from opening the voting lines, but right now the Sing-Off Top 4 are trying to survive their hardest challenge yet. For the first time this season, the songs have been chosen by our trio of judges. Next up, a Denver street posse with a wild rap-a-pella style. We asked our experts how Urban Method has been keeping the beat every week.
Urban Method has brought such a distinct style to the show because of the hip-hop element.
That was so good!
Urban Method's really interesting. They're taking a lot of the things that they know about the studio and they're applying it to live performance, and it's very effective.
Nobody missed a band in that one. That was great.
Mike has that swag that you'll go pay and see. But Urban Method had to show that they're not just a group based around Mike.
They had a couple of weeks of really harsh criticism because the females in the group weren't really stepping up.
Liz and Katie, you guys did the lead. I wish you were stronger.
We're glad that they actually took our advice because you've seen some things come out of Katie that we never knew existed.
And they're back. They're back better than they started.
We really want to see Urban Method super solid. They vacillate between being amazing and being really good. And to be on par with the rest of the groups on the show, they have to be just stellar.
Okay, Sean, what do you guys have in store for Urban Method?
Well, Nick, Urban Method has got that hip-hop appella thing on lock. When you hear Mike rap, his delivery is always intense, and he's such a showman. And Katie has become this season's actually breakthrough performer. So we wanted them to combine the strengths in hopes that they do their thing and shine. So we chose Kanye West, All of the Lights, featuring Rihanna.
Ah, all right, thank you, Sean. Aiming to blaze a rap appella path to the championship, performing All of the Lights by Kanye West, here is Urban Method.
All of the lights, turn up the lights in here, baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this.
Something wrong, I hold my head. MJ gone, our king is dead. I slapped my girl, she called the feds. I did that time, I spit that bread. I'm headed home, I'm almost there. I'm on my way, I'm headed up the stairs. Surprise, someone replacing me. I had to take them to that ghetto university.
Exciting. You guys do that the best. You shine when you blend the hip-hop with the harmonies and all of that. And it's so good now that we have, you know, a standout in Katie who just came out of nowhere and just knocking everybody out the box right now. You become stronger. And with each episode, you guys became better and better. I loved seeing you guys evolve in this competition. It was awesome. Mike, as always, dude, you know what you do, big bro. You go in, man, and it's coming down to the wire, guys. This is what it's all about. And you are showing that you are in it to win it. So great job, man.
Ben?
That was a great build of arrangement. It just kept the tension building and building. And you had a really mature way of hanging on to that, but keeping it exciting. The middle harmonies were shimmering. And that's Ozzy, whose name I haven't uttered the whole time. Nice work, Ozzy. Ozzy, Kim, and Liz, like, you guys were really locking there. Obviously, then Katie breaks out and then just takes it to another level. Mike's lead. I really liked that you sang in a way that just was very comfortable. And then you came back into rap and you went back into singing. The way you did that was really honest. That might have been my favorite performance of you guys. Nice work.
Sarah?
It seems like you guys have just blossomed into this whole other entity. I mean, you show so much confidence on stage now, and it's really, really exciting to watch from here. I also wanted to mention that the mic trick, I haven't seen anybody do that, and I thought that was really, really cool. And I liked that it lingered for a minute. It shows that you guys are really thinking about how to make your arrangements stretch and how to make the amount of instruments you have on stage really stretch and speak for you. That was awesome. I loved it.
All right. Thank you, Sarah. And we'll learn soon if Urban Method will float into the final round. Thank you, guys. If you want to keep the music rolling through the holidays, pick up the new album, The Sing-Off, Songs of the Season, available now, featuring beloved holiday songs recorded by your favorite groups from this year. Coming up, the judges' soulful pick for the smooth operators of Afro Blue. Three groups will explode into the championship, but one will fizzle out. The Sing-Off is on.
That was incredible to hear Ben say that this was his favorite performance of ours of the whole season. It was just like, thank you.
We're just a week away from our electrifying finale, where this season's top contenders plus superstar artists will take the Sing-Off stage. Right now, our esteemed judges are running the show, putting the top four to the test in the Judges' Choice Challenge. Next up, a DC group with deep roots in classic American music. Let's see why the judges have been swept away by Afro Blue's perfect blend.
Three little birds sat on my window.
Afro Blue are the cool kids of jazz. They take this really highbrow version of music and find a way to make that accessible for the everyday Joe.
I loved Afro Blue from the second they took the stage. They've got chops, they've got loads of personality, and I relate to them because they're students of music.
Doesn't take much to make me happy.
My favorite performance was American Boy.
Take me to
I love the way that they did that. It sounded good, it looked good, it was good.
You'll be my American boy.
They have so much potential. What stops them is themselves.
You guys are so good, you might overthink parts of the arrangement. You lost me a little bit.
Picture perfect memories.
We've had some ups and downs with Afro Blue being so complicated, but they've really seemed to crack the code when they were singing Need You Now by Lady Antebellum.
It's a quarter after one. I'm all alone and I need you now.
Everybody got goosebumps. I get goosebumps when I think about it right now.
To win this whole thing, Afro Blue have to understand that every song doesn't need a jazz chord, it just needs some heart.
Well, Ben, what song did you guys pick for Afro Blue?
Well, Afro Blue have such a classic sound, and they're just masters of the traditional chords and traditional jazz sounds, and they're at their best when they're combining that with some emotion and some heart. So we chose Sam Cooke's A Change Is Gonna Come.
All right, thank you, Ben. Trying to show America why they deserve to land in the championship, performing A Change Is Gonna Come by Sam Cooke, here's Afro Blue.
I was born by the river in a little tent, and just like that river, running ever since. It's been a long,
Afro Blue. Leaving it all up on the stage tonight. Ben, they do you proud on that one?
Oh, yeah. I'm really happy for you guys. How good was that? Christy, that was just, you just killed it. You know, you'd figure this song was in your sweet spot, but that really, that just really pulled out something from you guys. Now, I mean, you guys just made a record there. That was a record. I'll buy that. Yeah, it's like you guys were born 50 years ago. That was completely in the zone. I thought that was really good. Nice work, guys.
Sarah?
I got really emotional watching that performance, and I'm even getting a little choked up right now. My eyes were just filling with tears because I feel like we just saw you guys return to where you were supposed to be this whole time. You know, I feel like we maybe confused you along the way, and my God, that vocal, oh my God. Otherworldly, my friend. Christy, you are an angel. And all of the rest of you, you sounded like one voice behind her. That is so incredibly hard to do. I'm so proud of you guys. That was just phenomenal. That was amazing.
Sean.
Man. My God, man. That was absolutely soul-stirring.
Y'all straight took us to church on that. That has such a spirit and such a strong, soulful, just wailing. It was honest. It was melancholy. It was everything that Sam Cooke's song originally was, but how you guys made it a cappella. I could hear this on the radio. I could hear this live. I could see the video. It was so beautiful, guys. That was the best performance y'all did.
All right. Thank you, Sean. We'll find out in a bit if Afro Blue will be elevated into the top three. Thank you, Afro Blue. After the break, we'll see if the Ivy Leaguers of the Airs can ace their final exam with a college party classic that gets everybody shouting. When the music ends tonight, the voting begins on The Sing-Off.
I'm just so incredibly proud of every single member of this group, and I love them all so, so dearly. I'm just grateful, so grateful.
Biggest Loser.
I have a million things to be thankful for. Saving my life. I'm not going to cry about this.
Then, on a special night, Wednesday, 9, 8 Central, the celebration continues with reunions.
We are getting the family together.
And surprises.
We're getting married.
People all coming together and helping one another. That's what The Biggest Loser is all about.
I'm so incredibly proud.
New Biggest Loser two-night Thanksgiving event this Tuesday and Wednesday on NBC.
Everything is on the line tonight as our top four try to take that final step towards sing-off victory. Only three of them will stand tall in next week's life-changing finale, but first, they gotta survive the Judges' Choice Challenge. The final group is a charismatic force that steered clear of elimination with crowd-pleasing performances. We asked the judges what makes them smile about the fun-loving guys of the Dartmouth Airs.
The Dartmouth Airs are rooted in university a cappella tradition. Where they stick out is that they have a theatrical edge to them. We're not going
to take it. Out of all the guys in the competition, I think they're the most explosive. We're not going to take it.
No, we ain't going to take it. They blend humor. See the horse, ride a cowboy. And high energy performances and an emotional sensibility that is unique to them.
Their Queen performance to me was the most memorable.
And they were smart to close it with Michael, and he just took it on home. It was godlike. It was very cool.
Remember, I didn't write a single thing down at judges' table. I was just in awe. That was my favorite performance of this entire competition.
for the Dartmouth Airs to win this competition, it's going to take them to show us that they're more than just entertainers on stage, but they can be Sony recording artists.
We are down to the final four, and any little mistake can send you home. They're going to have to just really nail it.
All right, Sarah, what track did you guys choose for the Airs?
Well, the Airs are so theatrical and have so much heart and are a ton of fun to watch on stage. So we wanted to give them a song that would let them bring a party to the stage with them. So we chose the Isley Brothers and Shout.
Very nice. Thanks, Sarah. All right, trying to get the judges and America singing along, performing Shout by the Isley Brothers, here are the Dartmouth Airs.
Sing off. Well, you know you make me wanna to kick my heels up and throw my head up and throw my head up and come on now, don't forget to say you don't forget to say You know you make me wanna shout. Yeah, take it easy. A little bit something else. 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 A little bit louder now.
Sarah, how do they handle your choice?
Hey, yay! You worked the room. Michael. 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 You perform like you've been doing this for like 35 years. And you walk around as if you were born on this very stage and we have come to your home and it's your birthday or something. I mean, this is, it's ridiculous. And the boys, I just love you so much. You have so much heart and you guys are working your butts off and it's so much fun to see and to be a part of. There were some pitch problems because I think you were jumping for the rafters. And by the end, I was clearly singing and clapping along. So you guys are such a special, special group, and I'm so glad you're here.
Sean?
If Dartmouth Airs were like sold in like a supermarket, the instructions would say, instant party, just add water. Mike, you are a freaking superstar, boy. This song actually, you know, exemplifies who you guys are. It was Dartmouth Airs at its best. It was great. It was good job. It was a little, like, you know, flarp. And I think it was just because of the fact that, you know, y'all were doing a lot of jumping and backflips and somersaults. So, again, I pardon that. But overall, you guys showed what Dartmouth Airs is all about. So, good job.
Ben?
I grew up on exactly these kind of records. Like all I listened to when I was a kid, all I knew that existed were like Sam and Dave and the Isley Brothers and Otis Redding and James Brown, all this stuff. And Michael, you're a classic singer. I haven't really heard a singer do what you're doing really convincingly for me, that moves me in that way, since I was a kid listening to those records. And you're a total star. The rest of the group, you're all working together towards the same things. It's still causing some pitch train wrecks, which are just, when you've got a group that big, you got a tighter margin for error, and sometimes it does show. But Dan, you were nailing it on the swing parts. When you had longer notes to work with, then it was sounding really, really great. That was a load of fun. Thanks, guys.
All right, well said, judges. And the Airs are just moments away from learning their fate. Thanks, gentlemen. Remember, for behind-the-scenes videos, blogs, and tweets from all your favorite contenders, go to NBC.com. Over two ferocious rounds, the top four gave us every ounce of vocal strength they had. The judges are conferring, and when we come back, we'll hear the results. Only three groups can move on to next week's live finale, where your votes will crown the winner. To sing off, hold that note.
This whole process has been such a phenomenal experience. We all have grown as people, as musicians, which is also a blessing to be in this position. So we're really happy with both our performances, and yeah, we'll see what happens.
It's judgment time. America's top four groups just put it all on the line through two high adrenaline rounds of competition. They are Pentatonix, Urban Method, Afro Blue, and the Dartmouth Airs. Three of these groups will be singing their hearts out in next week's live finale. But one group's journey will end right now in heartbreak. I have the results here in my hand. All of these groups came here with a dream, and they've pushed themselves to the limit. They've put their hopes and their voices on the line. But only three can contend for the title. The first contender that will definitely advance to the Sing-Off Championship is... Urban Method! Congratulations! You made it. You're in the live finale next Monday. Three groups remain, but only two will earn a spot in the final show. The next group that's still in the chase for the title is... Pentatonix! You're safe. Congrats. We'll see you next week's live finale. Afro Blue and the Dartmouth Airs. Only one of you can advance to the final round. After a tough deliberation, the judges have not yet reached a final verdict. To help them make their ultimate decision, each of you must reprise what you feel was your most impactful song of the season. When it's over, the judges will consider this encore, as well as every performance from this season, and choose one of these groups to join Urban Method and Pentatonix in the finale. First up, with their do-or-die sing-off encore, here is Afro Blue.
Can we get away this weekend? Take me to Broadway. Let's go shopping. Maybe then we'll go to a cafe. Let's go on the subway. Take me to your hood. I've never been to Brooklyn and I'd like to see what's good. Dressed in all your fancy clothes. Sneakers looking fresh. You got the muff on those shell toes. Walking that walk. Talking that slick talk. You'll be my American boy. Boy.
That was Afro Blue with their song from Week 3, American Boy by Estelle featuring Kanye West. They just made their plea for the judges to push them into the championship. Now, their rivals have to get the judges on their side. Hoping to keep the sing-off dream alive, here are the Dartmouth Airs. The Dartmouth Airs with their song from Week 7, Somebody to Love by Queen. Both groups have given their last chance encores. Now they gotta hold tight while our experts make their most important decision of the season. One group will advance to the live finale a week from tonight. The other is about to face the music. The sing-off sings on.
Maya Rudolph is falling in love with guest star Jason Lee.
His hands are so rough.
When he touches me, I feel as though I'm being sandblasted.
His daughter's love, however, cannot be bought.
How do you like your new doll?
It's dead.
Help me.
A new Up All Night, Wednesday at 8, 7 Central on NBC.
Well, I can't express to you how difficult this is for us, but ultimately we have to think of the entire season, as Nick said, and I chose the group that, for me, I always was moved to an emotional place and had a wonderful reaction from it. And they're really consistent, and I chose the Dartmouth Airs.
All right, Sean, which group won your vote?
Well, it's hard because, you know, I guess you could say I'm emotionally involved with both of them, you know, and I think they're both great. And although they may not have been as consistent throughout the season, I felt like this group has the potential of actually having a long-standing career in music and making albums and records and That's why I chose Afro Blue.
Ben, looks like you're the tiebreaker. Who's it gonna be?
Well, this sucks, Nick. I have to go with who was connecting the most consistently over the season, and that's the Dartmouth Airs.
Dartmouth Airs, you did it! You made it to next week's live finale. Congratulations. Afro Blue, come on down, guys. All season, you guys elevated the music tradition you hold so dear. And we were so honored to have you grace our stage each and every episode. You guys are incredible, incredible singers. Danielle, do you have any final thoughts as you guys say goodbye tonight?
You know, this has been such an amazing, incredible, stupendous, spectacular. It's just been quite the journey for Afro Blue. We're just a class at Howard University. And you know, here we are at the sing-off in the top four. So, you know, we've learned so much. We're gonna take this with us wherever we go, and I'm sure we're gonna go lots of amazing places from here.
Absolutely. I just want to say personally, thank you guys so much. You made it so fun to come to work each and every day and be a part of this. Thank you guys so much, and best of luck to you. All right, now I'll ask you to raise your mics one last time. Leaving the sing-off with their swan song, here's Afro Blue.
We've only just begun.
That was Afro Blue singing We've Only Just Begun by The Carpenters. Don't forget, all the great songs you heard tonight are available on iTunes. Okay, America, it's your turn to cast your votes and choose the champion. Which group will take the sing-off title? Will it be Pentatonix? Urban Method? Or the Dartmouth Airs? As we give you the voting info, let's look back at some highlights from this season's performances.
Pentatonix raised the bar all season long. If you want these masters of the remix to take the title, vote by calling 1-877-6-SING-01 or text 1 to the number 97979. Urban Method brought a hip-hop style that changed the game for good. To help these musical mavericks win the crown, vote by calling 1-877-6-SING-02 or text 2 to the number 97979. The Dartmouth Airs unleash their big sound to rule the school. To push these high-octane undergrads to sing off glory, vote by calling 1-877-6-SING-03 or text 3 to the number 97979. Voting opens at the end of the show and closes November 27th at 9 a.m. Eastern. You can vote up to 10 times per method. Calls are toll-free from landlines. Text message and data rates may apply. For more info and to vote online, go to NBC.com. We started off with America's 16 best vocal groups, and now just 3 contenders remain. Only one will earn enough votes to win the recording contract, the cash, and the sing-off title. We'll announce the winner on the sing-off live finale 1 week from tonight, Monday, November 28th at 8 p.m. It's going to be a night packed with awe-inspiring musical numbers. We'll have special guests, our very own judges will perform, plus our 3 finalists and all your favorite groups from this season will be back to sing and celebrate as we crown the champion. It's going to be a night to remember. Until then, I'm Nick Lachey, signing off from the sing-off. Good night.
Tonight on Rock Center, The Scandal. We have another interview that may change more minds on the Penn State scandal. A young man who spent years inside Jerry Sandusky's inner circle. He has told Natalie Morales his story.
Did he zero in on you, or was he equally paying attention to all of the boys at the time?
I guess he took a liking to me.
Also, Kate Snow has a very personal reason to speak with a group of Penn State professors about the scandal, and she hears a startling admission.
Did any of you know Jerry Sandusky?
Never knew him personally.
But I was aware that there was this rumor circulating about him.
You were?
Yes.
Also here tonight, Rahm's Way. What is the fierce political operative turned Chicago mayor so determined to deny?
That won't happen, so don't worry about it.
Never going to happen.
Not. What part of it is that I'm not getting across?
I think that'll come as a surprise to some people.
I don't care. Maybe you all got your profiles wrong. You ever thought of that?
Also tonight, what is the actual price of happiness? They've actually attached a number to it. And here in our studio this evening, Betty White, a pioneer of television and comedy, still hot and still going after 7 decades in show business. That and more on Rock Center starting now. Good evening from New York. It was just a week ago on this broadcast, we aired Bob Costas's interview that changed the way a lot of Americans saw this unfolding sex abuse scandal at Penn State. It was a very frank conversation, part of a very dark story that has continued to unspool since that night. Tonight here live in the studio, Bob will be back with us to talk about the latest. But first tonight, we are airing another exclusive interview that could change the conversation yet again. Tonight, NBC's Natalie Morales sits down with a young man named Frankie Probst. He says, beginning when he was 10 years old, he and Jerry Sandusky did everything together.